Hello guys, Javad is here. In this video we are going to learn how to use a scattering tool or multiple asset placement in Enscape, in Revit, and in any 3D software that you use. You can follow along, it doesn't really important because this is a Enscape feature, not a Revit specific feature. To use this tool, you need to go to the Enscape window, and also you need to have Enscape 3.2 or earlier version of Enscape to be able to use a scattering or multiple asset placement tool. For example, in this project, let me change the time of the day to see it better. We are going to place trees in this site. If it was, for example, version 3.1, or previous versions, you needed to place them one by one in Revit or any 3D software that you are using. Especially for example, for Revit, you can't scatter with Revit itself. You can do some things with some works, and so you have some workaround with Dynamo, but it's not that straight. But in Enscape 3.2 and earlier versions, you have a asset placement or dynamic place asset placement, and you can do it very easily. To do that, go to the asset library in here, and then when your asset library is loaded, you have an option in here which is multiple asset placement, or in another way we can say it is scattering. You have three modes for scattering. You have rectangular mode, radial mode, and bucket selection, which will select a surface and it will detect the surfaces for you. For example, let us start with the bucket selection, and I will use radial and rectangular mode in another way. For this purpose, for trees, because we want this surface, we are going to use bucket selection. After selecting your scattering mode, you need to specify which assets you want to use in your set. To do that, for example, let's go to the foliage and vegetation category, and in this category you are going to use trees. Let's go to the trees tag in here, and we are going to choose about 7 or 8 family. The more family you would select, the more randomized group you have. For example, if you would choose one family, it just places them randomly. You don't have a randomized asset types too. So it depends on your need, and you can specify it very easily. For example, let's select this one. Just selecting them, I don't care about the exact thing. Or let's select this one too, and this one. Okay, that's great. And let's select the surface for ourselves. As you can see, the magic happens and you have all of the assets. But before seeing the final result, you have some adjustment that you can do. The first and the most important option is the density. It is really obvious when you put it in the lower number, the distance between each object will be much lower, and when you put it at the end, the distance between objects will be lower. But when it is in at the first, it will be very long between any, it will be a long distance between any assets together. Let's put it on a lower number, something like that. And don't worry, for example, if you have a wrong asset in here, for example, I don't want this, and this, you can delete them individually after the placement. So don't worry, you can modify them one by one after the placement. Okay, that's great. The next one is the distribution mode. When it is random, it is obvious it is random, but we have other methods. We have jitter. When you go up, jitter is something between random and uniform. Let me place it on uniform Uniform is great, for example, putting cars in the parking lot and those kind of things. But for trees, jitter and random are better options. For example, let me put it on jitter and let's bring the density to something a little bit, maybe lower, and let's select some other trees in here, more trees. Okay, that's great. And let's bring the density down, something like this, and let's put it on random. I like random more for vegetation, especially if you are simulating something random, not a grid, for example, grid of trees. Okay, that's great. Then you need to confirm your placement, but before that, you have a random rotation that I will talk about this one in cars and people, not in here. You need to just click on confirm placement, and then you have your placement ready, and then the last step that you need to do, you can apply chains. But before that, if you would uncheck this one or this one, you can see, we can see any difference right now. So let me bring them back or even choose more, and then click on apply chains. And you need to wait until all of the assets has been placed in Enscape window and even in your 3D software window. If you don't want to see the updates in your 3D software right now, you can pause the live update in Enscape tab. Okay, as you can see, magic happened and we have all of the assets in here. We can change we can't change the placement method and the randomized method and also the density after placement. You need to decide it bit beforehand. Okay, let's go for example in this hallway in here, and let's place some people and let's use rectangular and radial way of asset placement. For example, let's go to the asset library. We need to wait until our asset library is loaded, and then we need to go to the people category and let's go to the asset placement and multiple place asset placement, and let's use rectangular part. For to use rectangular part, just click once and then you need to specify the second part. Don't worry about the width of it. You can change it after that. For example, let's place it in here. And also you can change the position of these points after that too. And then let's make the width a little bit bigger. And let's select some, for example, people. The more people you would choose, the more randomized set of people you would have. So that's, it depends on you, and let's bring it for example in here, but let's make the weights smaller. Let's bring it for example in here and bring it in here, and let's change the density to a bigger thing. As you can see the difference in here. Let's see the preview for selected area. To do that, you need to use offline assets or download. You need to wait to download all of the assets to see the previews. You can see the previews, and the randomized part is not that great because we have used assets with the same character. You need to change the assets to fit better. Okay. And another option that I'm going to talk, for example, you can see it's not that great in here. Let's bring it down. And then we have another option, which is random rotation. When you use random rotation, it will randomize the rotation of each person. But if you would put it on uncheck random rotation, it will face them in one way. It doesn't make that sense in people, but in cars, it is really obvious. When it is unchecked, all of the cars are facing in one way, but it's when it's checked, the cars are randomized in rotation two. And that's it, and click on confirm placement, and you need to click on apply change, and you have the assets that you want. Okay, now we have all of the people too, and let's just tell an example for radial part. to see the radial way of working too. For radial part, for example, let's go in here. For example, you want to create a group of people. Let's go to the dynamic placement and let's put it on radial. You need to click on the center of the circle, and then you need to specify the radius of it, and then you can bring the density up, and you can randomize the rotation too. You can put them in jitter mode or uniform, for example, if you want to create some queues or those kind of things, you can use uniform in this part too. Okay, that was it. I hope this video has been so helpful for you. If it was, please don't forget to like that video to help us create more videos like this. And if you want to learn all of the new features for Enscape 3.2, I have uploaded another video for that. I will put the link in here. Go there and watch that too. I will see you on the next session.